She's returned, Geralt. After all these years.
The man who meets the hunt returns to this world. I returned.
Alright, what's happening, my friends? Welcome back to some more Witcher 3 Wild Hunt gameplay. We are just chilling here in Down Warren, about to finally, well, turn a page and leave the bog behind us. We've spent the past few episodes here unraveling a mystery. There's still things that remain unknown, you know? Like, the crones, they just basically disappeared. A quick appearance from them. They definitely look like some interesting characters. Would love to square off against them sometime down the road. Don't know if it's gonna happen, though. But we discovered that Gran, from the orphanage, is in fact the Bloody Baron's wife, yes, who went missing some time ago. So we've managed to track her down, and now we need a new lead to direct us Ciri's way. We've got a couple of options here as far as that main quest line goes. Let's take a look at the map here, and I'll show you all what I'm deciding to do. First off, I've got this marker set up here. I wouldn't say dire need. But I'm in need of some repairs. I wouldn't mind finding a proper, you know, a smithy. There's no forge here in Down Warren. I'm gonna try this joint here. And then what I think I'm gonna do is, if there's nothing here, I'll probably end up stopping at this. You know, I gotta figure, if the town has a notice board, it probably has a blacksmith, you know, or an armorer. And, well, that's kind of making, you know, it's pointing us where we're actually gonna be heading here. Because we've got the two options. We can either ride for Oxenfurt and try and track down Tamara, you know, and get her side of the story, and hopefully gain a little info on Ciri's whereabouts that-a-way. Well, in fact, I think we're really just going to have words with Tamara for the Baron's sake. You know, it's as a favor to the Baron, and I think the Baron is still withholding some information involving Ciri. And so I figure if I stop by here with news of his wife, we may get a little bit more, you know, a little bit more intel involving Ciri, which is good for the Witcher. And so what I want to do is I want to get back towards Crow's Perch. I think I'll handle it one little task at a time. We'll head back for Crow's Perch, report in with Philip Stranger, the Bloody Baron. And I mean, there's a couple of things I left on the notice board here, including a contract, I think, for a Shrieker. And we've got a couple of minor things like the fights and Gwent, which is always a good time, and probably a great means to make a little coin, earn a few Gwent cards, and acquire a little XP in the process. So here's the goal. We're going to stop by here and check in on this. If we have a forge, then that's great. If not, well, I'll just continue to set off on my way. I think I'll do a little bit of exploration here. We'll hit up a few of these points of interest. I'm not going to go. I mean, there's a lot out there. There's a lot out there, and all of that, you know, after the experience on the far side of, you know, Midcops and Black Bow. We know that this could take several episodes to really go through all of this, so I'm going to be a little selective here. I'll probably hit up a few points of interest along the way, stop in this town this episode, maybe get all the way to the Crow's Perch. I'm not really sure, but it's never going to happen if I don't get moving. So let's get rolling out here, leave the north end of town, say farewell to the bog and the baddies that live here. Yes. And of course, we never really got a full picture of what happened after the Whispering Hillock, you know. The druidess who took on the form of the Black Beauty, you know. Did she save the orphans, and what happened to them? And where did the crones go? And what happened to Gran, you know? These are things that have been left a mystery, you know. So I'm hoping that by returning to the Bloody Baron, that maybe he'll want us to return here and perhaps convince Gran to return to him. That's a little messed up. Look at that. All the little tufts of grass there floating in the air. That's fine, though. That's fine. Run hard here, Witcher. I probably should have just called in. Actually, I've come right off my line. I started following the trail. the GPS rather than my personal marker. Oh, that's not a good thing. We've got a green glow, a nasty green glow in the distance here. Hanging right around this city wall as well. Look at that, look at that. Here we go. A little wraith action. Fine. I will deal with you, you foul specter. Get out of there, Victor. Watch out for that triple shot combo. It hits hard and it hits fast. Maybe I should just leave them be. This is the bloody town I'm looking for, though. Haunted by wraiths. Where's it going? Wants no part of you, Vetcher. You've clearly spooked it. Which is saying quite a bit, considering it's a ghost. Yes. The Reardon Manor. Alright. New location discovered. Oh, watch out now. Get that trap down. And prepare to get your shields up. Doesn't look like they'll leave that little area there. I don't know. Oh, look at it. It's taunting you. It's daring you to attack. There we go. My shield's up here. Alright, let's get a good look at the... You know, get right into this town here. They don't seem to want to leave it. They're all buggered up over here. Look at this. Stupid wraiths. No one said they were the smartest creatures. I don't know what the Vetcher's doing. Apparently neither is Geralt. No. Not the smartest creature. What he was targeting. Oh, damn, there's that triple shot. Gotta watch out for it. Gotta watch out for that. Wow, it did that hit? Can't believe that. Oh, I got hit by another one. I'm not suffering the full brunt of that triple shot, so... And I'll tell you, attacks 2 and 3 on that thing come in super fast. You know, if you get staggered by that first slice with the sword, you're eating the lantern in the back end as well. Yeah, you know. Alright, looking good here now. Alright, awesome. Is that the last of them? It looks like it. We have quieted this ghost town on this eve, yes. I'm sure they'll return, though. We've merely cast their essences onto the wind. I'll tell you, the wraiths, they've always got some decent stuff, you know. Some good dust, you know. Little essence of wraith. Is this the town? Well, oh my. With all these wraiths hanging about, I have no doubt there's several bodies dangling from it. Or is it a well? You know what, it looks like... Actually, I don't know. It looks like they were thinking about building a well here, and then something went awry. Something went wrong. Damn it. We got something over there. Did I leave one of the wraiths alive? Maybe. I don't know. I'm sure this little... Well, what was it called? Reardon Manor. This little township. This little plot of land. I'm sure it's got a story to tell. We could, in fact, be directed here in some future mission. I've got more important things to worry about right now, you know. So I think I'm just gonna move on. Where's the horse? I left myself, some remains over here. Here we go. What are we getting? Little emerald dust? I mean, that's great stuff, you know. Anyway, looking at the Vitcher's sword, you can see we've already crossed the, end of the red line. We've already crossed into the red zone, so... Alright, well, I think I'll just bypass this, you know. If I pass through it, then I pass through it. If I skirt it, it's not a big deal. I don't know for sure, but I'm pretty confident there's gonna be, what you know, a smithy over here of course, that's what I'm looking for. Alright, we'll hit up a couple of those points of interest along the way. Let's roll. Quick saving it. Alright. Oh, what do we have over here? Something that goes bump in the night. I'd almost say it looks like Neckers. And of course, my silver sword, bloody damage. You know what, I should have bought that one silver sword I had seen. Or was it? Was it something I could have bought, or was it something that I could have crafted? I can't remember now at this point. Watch out there, Vitcher. There you go, sir. Well played. Die, you foul scum. Yes, damn monsters. Damn neckers. Alright. Lesser green mutagen, I'll take it. You know they always travel in the goddamn packs too. We could be closing in on a nest of theirs. In fact, there were a couple of points of interest out here. What is that up there? Could very well be a nest. One more necker hanging around over there. Let's get my my crossbow out. Send in a warning shot. Oh, I got him too. Well done there, Victor. Power strike! Damn it. Oh, he's actually doing a little bit of damage. And then he just fell over and died. Yes. That's what happens when you try to attack the Vitcher. Vitcher's blood is clearly toxic to the creatures. He got a good taste of it, and then he... Well, it cost him his life. Alright, what are we dealing with here? I mean, this looks like something. I don't know. It's giving me a bad feeling. A bad vibe, in fact. Oh, here we go. Some sort of fallen soldier. A couple of crowns on him. He won't be needing those where he's going. No. No. Alright, well. Let's just set off on foot. We'll travel the woods. Swiftly. Left Roche back there. In fact, I can grab some ingredients along the way. Here we go. I'm seeing something. What is it? An old abandoned site. Doesn't seem to be so abandoned anymore. Actually, you know what these are? These are those sites that if I take down the baddies. One more. We got the leader coming right out to meet me, you know. I like that, you know. I like that the leader, he doesn't sit back and wait for his men to die. No, he gets right in there front lines. Oh, damn. We've loosened an arm here, Vitcher. Look at the leader is thinking twice about this now. He's like, what have I gotten myself into? You will die alongside your fallen comrade, my friend. Burn alive! Yes. There we go. Give you a small taste of hell before I send you there. Anyway. Let's end this. Come on. Oh, damn. Oh, you've been knocked stupid there, Vitcher. Oh, he's playing hard now. He's fighting hard, but it cost him his life and his head. Yes. And down you go. Is that all? Was there really just two of them? Maybe the rest of them haven't clued in. They've clearly been boozing it up here on this eve. As renegades like to do. Once the sun goes down, yes. Okay. A posse of deer moving into the area. A big posse as well. Alright, there must be more here. Yeah, there has to be, since the site hasn't been completely cleared yet. Here we go. Come on, Vitcher, get the bloody sword out, sir. Witcher coming into the camp with fisticuffs out. Come on. Use your noodle, sir, please. Damn it. Cut him down! Oh, cut him in half, in fact. Cut him in half. Screw cutting him down. Right to the face. Stuck that bolt right in his eye. Oh, did I take an arm? It looked like it. I'm not sure, though. This guy looks like he's getting ready to go back to his bow. He was the bowman, wasn't he? Yeah, here we go. Bring your bow out. I want to put this into practice. My new ability. Oh, that's fantastic. I can't wait until I'm redirecting them back at the man shooting them at me. All Jedi style. Come on, one more, sir. Just for shits and giggles. Awesome. Here. Have a little bit back your way. How do you like that, sir? And that. Oh. We're filling his chest cavity full of these damn things.
He's done.
And we drive him through. And we put it to rest. And we allow... Well, this is great, because we pass time, or some time passes, we get into, the light of day. And if I get lucky here, we might have a smithy move into the area. There may be an active forge here. Definitely get some good coin, some good XP, so it's all worth it. We keep the people of Velen happy. That's awesome. Get my level up. That means full health, because I'll tell you, it was getting a little low back there after that last encounter. 120 XP, quite nice, and 50 crowns for my troubles. And I don't know if I'm going to bother looting the camp. I don't know if I'm going to bother looting the camp clean. But if there's something of value, a flawless diamond or something, screw the rope ladders. I've no interest. Oh, we'll take the meteorite ingot. They clearly will not be requiring such things. Those can come my way. These as well. Yes, yes. Oh, look at that. Master's armor repair kit. Awesome. Some crowns. All right, Vetcher, go easy on them. These poor refugees or whatever the hell they are. Look at this one. She's beautifying herself just for you, Vetcha. Yes, she is. Oh, it's a little... Hey, this is Pimp Daddy right here. Look at this. He's working a couple whores out of this camp or something. I don't know what's happening. That's what it looks like. All right. We've got an herbalist right here. The old broken rake. No, no. The herbalist must have some decent supplies over here somewhere. Let's see. The platter. No. Well, maybe not. Maybe not. All right. One kill King Foltest. Oh, they're still blaming me for that? Good lord. Anyway, let's have words with the man. Vitcher does not get on well with the herbalists and just those random merchants for some reason. Anyway, let's see what you got.
Got anything interesting?
Again, some sort of insult must have been given their guild. Do I have any honeycomb? I wanted to check the price on this stuff. I have heard that it may fetch some good coin out there with the merchants, herbalists, etc., etc. Does he have anything worth buying? We've got the Grave Hag decoction. Do I have that yet? I don't even know. We've got the Wraith decoction. I don't think I've got that. Whenever a single hit drains more than a third of vitality, a quench shield is activated, which protects against the next attack. That's pretty good, and you know what? I've got some Wraith mutagens. Oh, yes, I must splurge. I'm not sure if I've got it. I'm pretty sure I don't have it. I'll splurge and I'll spend the 80 on it. Why not? Let's buy it up. What else do we have here? Earth Elemental decoction. Won't be needing that for some time, will I? No, my last encounter with the Earth Elemental did not go well. I can't see myself claiming one of their precious mutagens anytime soon. We've got the Night Wraith decoction. Geralt's maximum vitality is increased with each foe killed. This increase lasts until he meditates or fast travels. You know what, 55, I'll risk that I don't actually have this uncovered yet. I'll risk it. Because I also have a Night Wraith or a mutagen, so I can put, I'll be able to do a little bit of brewing here at some point soon. Alright, what do I have that he may have his eyes set on? The Night Wraith trophy? No, I'm not willing to part with it, sir. You'd have to do better than that 33, that measly 33 crowns you were offering me to begin with. Oh, he likes his gold ruby ring, though. Look at that. He does like it. Well, that's going to offset the cost of my Night Wraith decoction that I just bought off of him. I'll keep my pure silver, though. Thank you, sir. Is there anything else that I should be considering here? A little alkalest for sale. Do I need it? I don't know. Let's have a quick look. How are my hard liquor supplies looking? I'm not sure. Look at all the mutagens I'm floating right now. Look at that collection. My god. I'm gonna have to upgrade some of them. Where is my alkalest? I'm not even seeing it. I'm seeing Dwarven Spirit. Alright, well that can be used as the hard liquor. I may be out of alkalest, in fact. Oh no, here we go. I've got one left. Should I splurge on it? 125 for his supplies. Yes, I think I will. Screw it. Probably foolish at this point, what with all that Dwarven Spirit. But I'll tell you, I'm not taking any chances moving forward. Oh, he's got some saltpeter here as well. I'd better grab a little bit of that. We'll spend the same. Another 125 on saltpeter just to have it. All right, I think that's probably good. I'm sure there's a couple other things in here that I could probably use that I'm just not aware of. But those are the chances you take at times. So I don't want to go through my entire bankroll here.
Farewell.
Vitcher, apparently he feels as though he bested the herbalist on this day. Oh, we've got a juggler in town here. Look at this. This must be some sort of traveling whorehouse slash circus. Yes, it's doubling as the circus. It's using the circus as a front. The whores are in back or something. I don't know. Just nasty. Anyway, let's take a quick look at the map here. And we're on track for this town. I think, should I cut through the wood and go and check this out? Why not? Why not? It'd be a good time. Let's find Roche. I don't think this is too far. But I'll get the horse in here anyway. Come on, horse. Quit your slacking. Let's roll. And I guess with that complete, quick save is in order. I'll tell you, I hope whatever we're walking into, if it's conflict, I hope it's human in nature. Here we go, a bandit camp, perfect. As my silver sword is just in ruin. It's in disrepair currently. Oh, look at this. Oh, dang. Oh, my. Oh, wow, they've got some serious archers in there. Oh, I need to carve right into their ranks here. Get up this damn hill. Get them to put these damn bows away, these scallywags. I don't care if I'm blocking arrows or not. There's three of them up there being wise asses with their bows. I don't appreciate it. I really don't. You got this. A pair of them have gone back to the bows. Gentlemen, give it a rest already, please. Vitcher's striking when he can, and now this one. Cut him down, Vitcher. Cut one of them in half. Take an arm or something, please. Let it be a lesson to the rest of them. If they're gonna pull out their bows, they're gonna lose limbs. Yes, they are. There we go. Did I do anything? No. Just killed him. Just a run-of-the-mill slaying, yes. Anyway. Better get my shields back up. Man, they've apparently come down. Damn it. Down they go again. What I should do is bloody well ignite that right there. That'll settle them down up on that hilltop. Oh, damn. Actually, it didn't really do too much, did it? I think it took one down. Look at this guy calling me on, this deserter. What's he thinking? Does he not realize who I am? Apparently not. Whoa, easy there, Vitcher.
Let's end this.
Nearly came off this little rise of earth here the hard way. Oh, nice! Nice. Fire your arrows at me, sir. I've no fear of such things. Yes. I'll give you a little taste of your own medicine. In fact, how do you like them apples, my friend? Dig his head, Vitcher, please. Do it. Oh, send him off the cliff. This is Sparta, yes. You bastard, you. Anyway, here we go. A couple of ham sandwiches. He was eating good up here at this hilltop. Alright, some blunt crossbow bullets, and I will take the small blackjack for resale. And let's hope for some good treasure. This is the motherlode right here. Iron ore, we've got emerald, we've got dwarven spirits, so some hard liquor. Clearly, it was fueling those three crossbowmen's bravery, yes. We had a crossbow, of course, in case there was some sort of technical issue with what they were wielding. Dark steel plates, amethyst dust. What is this? Split bolts. Oh, wow, got 20 of them. And some blunt crossbow bolts and some crowns. Well, let's go and have a look at that. Is that going to be firing two at once or something? What is this doing? This split bolt. I don't really know. I need 20 level of 22 just to wield the buggers. Alright, some bread. We'll take those. Grab the blackjack again for resale. We will loot it all. Oh, we got some booze. Again. Fuel for their courage. Because clearly they needed it, dealing with the Vitcher. Yes. Oh, take that. Take that. And plenty of remains to search here now at this point. Grilled pork, really. That's a meal I have yet to encounter out here. Alright, I think that's the last of it. I think I can probably safely move on, unless they've concealed something away. Very wily. In a real wily fashion. On the other side of that rock, but I'll guess no. Let's get the map up. I think we're pretty close to this one village now. Yes, we are. And I will simply ride for it. What is this now? Okay, now that's been cleaned out. That's the herbalist. All right. That was the abandoned site. This was the bandit camp. All right. Roche, where are you at, horse? Come on. Come now. Quickly. He seems to really be lagging behind. It's like he's I don't know. He's come up lame or something. He seems to be favoring one of his hooves. I don't know. Has he sustained some damage, perhaps? I'm not sure. Now, how am I getting across here, exactly? We've got something living down in this mighty gorge. Do you think you can hop this here, Roche? I don't know. It's not beyond the realm of possibility, but I don't think the horse can make that leap. I really don't. What do we have down there? Something.
Move it.
Something waltzing about. Oh, it's a big old bear. I say we just leave it. We just leave it, Venture. I know you would love to skin the creature. Take its hide. Devour its liver or its heart or something. Oh, what is this now? What is this? I don't even think this was on the map. Actually, this was probably will probably have been a point of interest that will be uncovered once I do check the notice board in that upcoming village. Take a little time and inspect right now. Is this the bear cave? Is this where he's living? I don't know. Do you dare brave this dark cavern, Venture? I guess you do. I'm definitely gonna get a quick save here, yes. There must be something of interest down here. Other than, you know, other than just some suent mushrooms. Maybe not. We may be battling something here in the... Oh, got some remains here. Really? That's it? Just mushrooms down here? Are you kidding me? What is this now? What is that? Is that just more mush? No, here we go. Temerian rye. No, not really much here, unfortunately. There seems to be multiple... entrances here. Or am I just seeing things? No. I think this is the way I came in. I think the other exit is probably gonna open... You know, open up into that one, that gorge I'm trying to avoid right now. What, with the big bear? Running a patrol up there, you know? Out on the hunt for some dinner. Well, here we go. Am I heading the right way? A big bridge right there. Oh, here we go. Alright. Alright, well, this'll do just fine. At least it's gonna get me over the gorge. It's not even a, well... I mean, it wouldn't take much effort. Oh, I can't even. There's the bear. You don't want to mess this up here, Vitcher. Get Roche in here. We'll make a proper leap on this. Where's the horse now? Down there with the bear. Oh, no, he's not. If we're not careful, we're going to end up down there, though. All right. Come on, Roche. Don't be so stubborn. Yeah. Stopping short on me. Get rolling. Oh, will he not jump it? Come on, Roach, you can make that leap. He's like, damn you, Vitcher, I'm not doing it. He's got an ingrown hoof right now or something. That's why he's favoring it. No, goddamn it, Roach. Fine. You go find drone food. Yes. For the next few days. I'm done with you. Not gonna make that leap for me. You bugger you. I'm just going down into the gorge. Screw it. I'm making a mountain out of a molehill here. Alright, and I think this is the town I'm trying to get to. Yeah. I didn't even have to cross the damn bridge. Leave Roche back there to think about what he's done. The decisions he's made here. He's infuriated the Witcher. Yes, he has. So you're that white one. I am, sir. Alright, we've got the tannin rack. What I need is a bloody forge, though. Tell you, this is a muddy old town, isn't it? Oh, we got some fighting. Look at this. A couple of guys sparring over here. Of course, we've got ourselves a vendor, a merchant of some kind. Still need a forge, though. I still need a forge. We're gonna get involved in this, I'm sure. Before we leave town, there will be blood spilled, yes. Knuckles bruised.
Sent my youngins to pick mushrooms yesterday. To the woods. Alone. You know how it is.
Here we go. No, no. Looks like we found ourselves a butcher. I'm not seeing any sort of forge, though. Here we go. See the anvil. Nice. Alright, wonderful. Wonderful. The blacksmith. Good day, sir.
Trusty arms for all sorts. Steel swords and strong maces for the menfolk. Engraved knuckle dusters for the ladies.
Alright, well. Oh. Well, we'll start with some Gwent. It's always a good time, you know. I don't know what it is about this card game. It is so well done. All right, now how am I looking for as far as my other decks go? We've got a couple of Scoia'tael, not much though. We've gotten a good collection of monsters and some pretty powerful cards as well. You know, I'd love to get this deck complete or to a point. You get it up to a point that I can actually use it in some of these games. Oh, here we go. We'll get him in there. Actually, I've got a couple now. Come on, get him over there. There we go. A couple Nilfgaardians. All right, for the time being, I guess we just stick with what I've got. Let's start it up. Oh, what's he using? Scoia'tael! All right. We shall get rid of our poor fucking infantrymen. And what else? What else have we? What did I have for weather cards? I think I'll probably get rid of the fog. That's not too bad an exchange, you know. I don't mind the siegeman. He plays an important role there when the catapults and the ballista, the trebuchet roll onto the battlefield, you know, because everything in there gets buffed. Okay, I don't know what this is. Should I go front line in it here? I'm not sure. I think what I'm going to try and do is avoid the front line and potentially use my Biting Frost this round. We'll play the ranged game here. Keep our distance. Alright. The Scoia'tael deck appears to be kind of the master of the ambush, you know? I think there's probably going to be a lot of guys like that can get called in. Alright. Let's roll the big guns out. For a slight lead, moving forward. I may have to bring out the fog of war and shut these screwballs down. In fact, that's precisely what I'm going to do. What are you gonna do now, sugar? Okay. I'll put the Biting Frost out as well. He's just gonna keep playing, is he? Just gonna keep playing. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Incredible. Hmm. Well, I've kind of buggered myself here, but you know what? I'll use a few. We'll get Sabrina out there. I mean, he's already down. There we go. The pass has come in. He's down to 3 cards. This is wonderful. I make a quick pass. Look at all the bloody the bloody dwarves he called in with that one card. That was incredible. Oh, and that's perfect. You know, a little more fog coming in. Because that's where they seem, that's where their strength is, you know, that mid-range, playing as the ambushers. And it's perfect because mostly everything I've got left, or I've got some real power here on the front line, which we'll put to use. To open. He doesn't really have much, he's got 2 cards left. You know, the one thing I need to watch out for right now will be the ambushers. I'm feeling good about this one, though. Perfect. Victory is had. Clear weather. That's all he had left. Alright, awesome. Quick little game. Put him in his place quite quickly, didn't you, Vesher? Yes, you did. Yes, you did. I'll take the coin. The coin is just an afterthought. What I'm really after is the prized card, you know? Okay. 20 crowns. Look at him getting real shovey. Oh my, sir. Not happy at all. Oh, we got the Keiran. Another monster card coming in. That's awesome. All right. Well, sir.
Trusty arms for all sorts. Steel swords.
Yes, yes. I've heard your sales pitch, sir. I don't need to hear it again. Thank you. I would, are you perhaps a master weaponsmith, my friend?
Master quality weapons. You capable of making them?
Who do you think I am? A Tory?
A Tory?
The master craftsman of Novigrad. Why, everyone's heard of him. Says he's retired now, so no. Ain't no one can do what you ask.
Oh, really? So there's but one master weaponsmith in all these lands? And he's retired, you say. Well, I'll have to entice him out of retirement somehow. I will need your services, though, good sir. Yes, I hope your crafting skills are a little bit better than your Gwent-playing skills. Yes. Geralt getting a few digs in here.
I'd like to craft something for
me. Get a few digs in here. You know, he's earned bragging rights after that, well, that one-sided victory. Okay, so let's see. What do I want to do? I want to repair. Actually, let's start with some doing a little buying and selling here. We'll get rid of these blackjacks and what have you. The Velen. Should I break these down? Am I gonna need it? Am I gonna need it? Maybe I should. Yeah, I think I will do that. We'll dismantle a couple of blades here. And recover the iron ingots. What is this? Ekamarahide, oh really? Alright, now, what is this now? Removing upgrades, I don't want to do that. Now, do I want to repair everything I've got? Do I need all of these bloody, you know, these gambesons and... I mean, I'm carrying 4 of the bloody things now at this point. They're all pretty good though, you know. What are they each weighing? 6... And then the other 2 are about a couple of pounds a piece. Plus whatever it is I'm wearing right now. This Spike Rug Akitan. Do I need it? It's light. I think I've got... you know what? To be perfectly honest, I think I have... Actually, I don't know. I don't know. I think I've got the diagram to actually craft this sucker up. Well, I'll have to think about it a little bit more. Let's get the repairs in here. I guess shall I repair all? What's it going to cost me? 282. Oh my. Oh my. Let's do it. Screw it. Might have been a foolish endeavor. Is he gonna want anything here? You know what I do have that he's gonna want will be... Oh, he doesn't want it! Oh, he's a weaponsmith, isn't he? No, he's a blacksmith. That is a weaponsmith. So that could be why he has no interest in my hides. But that's okay. There's another merchant in town here somewhere. Now, what's he have for diagrams? We've got a couple of journeyman's weapon repair kits. These seem quite pricey right now. Oh, it's because they're journeymen's. Well, I should include into that. How am I sitting for gear like that? I've got two amateur's weapon repair kits. You know what? I wasn't even thinking about that. I had the weapon repair kits right there. I could have done the work myself on that silver sword. Dang it. My weight's looking a little extreme here. I mean, I don't know. What am I... I'm really bogged down with something. With just a whole bunch of junk and stuff, you know? Look at all this stuff. Look at all this stuff I'm lugging around. Oh my god. Are the bolts weighing me down? I wonder. I don't know. At least I've still got 60 pounds worth there. Okay, we've got... Mastercrafted silver sword. Well, well, well. Diagram for that. Of course, I would need a master smith, wouldn't I? No, maybe not. Maybe not. Let's see, what else do we have here? Lots of stuff. Lots of different diagrams. I don't think there's anything there that I'm really too interested in. Now, hold on a second. You know what? I've been slaying myself some... You know, he doesn't want any of that stuff. Oh, here we go, here we go. The emerald dust. I mean, I could really collect some good coin from this. I've got quite a bit of amethyst dust. Maybe I should think about parting with some of it. Get rid of half of that stack just to try and recover a little bit of coin here. I mean, I was over 1,000 a little while ago. We're down to about half that now. All right, let's do about half the stack, maybe a little bit more. There we go, that's pretty good. The infused dust isn't really worth too much. The emerald dust, quite pricey. I've got a flawless emerald there. I'm sure that could be dismantled into... Well, if I take a look at it. Into an emerald, and the emeralds can be broken down into the actual dust. Alright, what I think I'm gonna do... is part with my emeralds and my, you know, my flawless emerald and my emeralds and really make some good money here, because I'm sitting with 7 piles of emerald dust. I mean, how much emerald dust do I really need right now, you know? So let's do it. He doesn't have enough. You're useless, sir. Truly. Mastercrafted saddle. Do I have that already? I'm not even sure. I don't think I have something quite that good. But you know what? Roche isn't getting anything new right now anyway. Being a real prick back at that one bridge. Back at that one bridge, yes. Alright, well, you know what I will do is I'll get rid of my... at least one of my emeralds here. Can I get rid of the other one? 137. You know, he's only got 81 left. Is there anything I can do with him at this point? Could maybe look into having something crafted here. I'd have to go down to the blades. Alright. I don't really need any steel swords. I'd be looking for something, you know, something that's really great as a silver sword, though. Alright, I need level 13 to actually be able to wield that. I could have him make me another serpentine silver sword, you know, then just be carrying around two of them. I mean, that might make sense, but, screw it. I'm not gonna bother with it. I'm not gonna bother with it. Let's move on. Farewell, sir.
So long.
I appreciated the game of Gwent. New quest of swords and dumplings, really. I guess that probably has something to do with what's-his-face. The master weaponsmith. In Novigrad.
Like winter.
We do have some embers. You know, the grindstone and the upgrade table for the armorer's repair table, or whatever you want to call it. I'll get my upgrades before I set off from here. My enhancements. But I'd like to take care of a little more business, and I would like to inquire about these fights that are taking place. Right here. Now, where did I see that one merchant? Yeah, he's right up here. He's not only selling goods, he's probably taking bets on these fights here, yes. Alright, maybe one more game of Gwent here as well with this fella. A game of Gwent, sir, yes, of course. I know some of you may just hate this, but I love this. These card games are great. They're great. Alright, and let's just roll. Actually, might as well get my monster card in there. The Karen, and oh, we've got a hero card. Even better. Look at this. This deck is shaping up to be something just spectacular. And you know what? Being the Witcher, he should have the monster deck as his go-to deck. You know? It should be a deck that is simply revered all around these lands, yes. Alright, the poor fucking infantryman. Goodbye. I don't want you in there. Good to see you, Zoltan. Alright, that's not looking too bad. Do I really need the two siegemen, though? Ah, screw it, I'll keep them. I'll keep them for shits and giggles. Let's play. You know, this is one hell of a big-ass piece of machinery, this ballista here. I may need both men to wield it effectively, yes. I don't know. Anyway, let's bring out Zoltan. Leading the charge here. Oh, look at this. Your doppelganger, Zoltan. Some black magic at play, clearly, yes. We'll bring out, we'll have Ves fighting alongside him, as it was meant to be. A little ranged action, I think I'd like to avoid any, you know, filling anything in here, because if he starts stacking things, stacking up this column deep, then I'll just go to my fog of war. And shut him down. Oh, bringing out the spy, really? Really? Now, what's happened here exactly? Clearly, I have. Oh no, there we go. I've got 19 now. He grabbed a couple of cards. Oh wow. It's gonna cost him a couple of cards to take the lead. Let's make it a little bit more costly for him. We'll put the Fog of War out there. And another spy coming out here. Oh my god. Oh damn. Alright, well, screw it. I'm passing. I'm doing no more. No more than that right there. No more than is what required here. Oh dang. Completely nullifying my forces. You prick, you. Well, I'll tell you, it cost him a few cards. It did. Despite the fact that he's dropped two spies at this point and claimed four extra cards, he's getting one more here for victory as well. You know. And the thing was that he really did get rid of a lot of crap in there. So I have to imagine whatever he's got back is probably pretty good. And we're seeing the effects of that here early on. And I have to win this, you know. Otherwise, I am shit out of luck. Let's start stacking things up here. Middle of the field. This makes me a little nervous. Because I'll tell you, he's got full test, and his full test has the same power as I did. Alright, now what am I gonna do here? I guess my best bet would be, you know, I better drop the reins. And we'll bring out Keira for victory. Alright, things all looking pretty square here moving into this final round. We've each got 5 cards. Now he still has his full test card. Oh, really? Who came in here? Goddamn Yarp and Zigrin. Really? That's the best we could draw? Are you kidding me? Unbelievable. Not good. I'm not feeling too confident about this last round here. I'm really not. That's right, sir. Keep dropping them and I'll be quite pleased. Those poor fucking infantrymen. Yarpin, get out there and slay that man, please. Get out there and destroy him, thank you. Oh yeah, he's looking pretty weak. He must have really been stacked thick with these, you know, these grunts, these pawns of the army, of the Northern Realms. We'll throw out my Crinford Reavers fellow here. Start sticking these suckers. Alright, the fog comes into play. I was kind of expecting something like that anyway, since he's got his full test fog of war card. We'll bring out our second man here. We're gonna need two of them to wield this ballista as it prepares to enter the battlefield. He's down. He must just be down to weather cards at this point, you know. That's fine. He's been utterly destroyed here in this final round. He passed it. He basically just forfeited the round and granted us victory. Very good. Very good. 20 crowns, I'll take it. And let's see, what am I getting? A ghoul. Perfect. Perfect. More monster cards. The more monster cards I'm claiming, the better. The better. All right, here's what I think I'll do. Rather than put you all through yet another little buying and selling session, I'll take care of my business with the merchant between episodes, tie up loose ends like that, and for the time being, actually, I think I could be running a little bit long here, but I wouldn't mind inquiring about these fights. Let's have a look at the notice board and see what's up. We've got a few different things here. Monster in my manor. That could be, yeah, that is reared in estate. We see mention of it right there. We've got a contract on God's know what on. I don't know what this is about. Looks like it's a contract, though. Good folk, walking the woods recently, I spied some odd tracks and couldn't for the life of me figure out what left them. Even though I've many a hunt under my belt, you know me. I'm not one to make a fuss, but I can't help but reckon they bode ill, and we all should be on guard. And if anyone's seen something or figures he can identify the tracks, come see me. There's a reward in it for you. He has Huntsman of LINDENVALE. And another contract. Oh my. Monster in the cemetery. Nothing made, no mention made of these fights here. Were all of those contracts, you know? Is the monster in my manor perhaps a contract as well? I don't know. Oh no. Anyway, who do I talk to about getting into a little Dottybrook here? The bookie.
What do they call you? Know how to fight?
The Geralt. Butcher of Blaviken.
Yes. Then enter the lists, my friend.
Good. Let's do it. Am I betting on myself here? What's happening?
I'm ready. Let's fight.
Good folk. Fish Gulper's finally found a foe. Right here, right now, on the field of honor, he'll face none other than Geralt of Rivia, the Hammer!
The Hammer? Well, try something that's a little more accurate, like the White Wolf, yes. Or the Butcher of Blaviken.
Spare me a minute before the fight, Master, please. Cut of your mugs plain as day. What am I beside ye? I just want to live. These days, streams are bereft, no fish for me to gulp. And they's given a sack of flour to the winner. Show some pity.
Don't
take a fall for
it. Listen to this guy. Don't fall for it, Vitcher. No. No chance, sir. It's not going to happen.
Not about to lose on purpose. If you want to win, you gotta beat me.
This man pulling out all the stops. Tugging on the Vitcher's heartstrings here. Ridiculous.
Come on, come closer.
The lengths some of these wily fishermen will go to earn a little coin. Ridiculous. Alright. Come on, Vitcher. Get in there. Put him down. Power strike his ass. Oh, damn. Knocked him a little stupid there. Actually, he's blocking most everything. These fights seem a little bit more involved here. Haven't even broken down his guard yet. He's doing some serious damage to me. Can I use my spells or anything? Oh, there we go. Now I'm getting somewhere. Get in behind him, getting a couple jabs in. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, damn. And I can't drink my swallow. This guy's one hell of a prized goddamn fighter here. I think we were trying to be hustle. I think he was trying to hustle us to begin with, yes. Ridiculous. I'm gonna have to play this really cautiously. There we go. Maybe I need to swing for the fences. The jabs are just not cutting it. avoid everything that's coming my way. Don't want to expose myself, you know. Keep my my flurries limited. Oh! Damn, Geralt coming in with a flying knee there. Another power strike. There we go, there we go. Oh, dang. Oh, man's getting beat down at this point. Geralt bringing in all the stuffs. Throwing backhands in there and everything. Oh, Lord. He's clearly tuckered the fisherman out. And victory is had in a really close fight there. Oh my.
Yes, we might have known.
We made it look
Richard
good.
Took fish gulper and fish plowed his gob. Near warmed my heart to see him renovate his head.
Not bad, not bad. Time to try your luck against Jonah. And then there's Smithy at the Inn of the Crossroads. Go to it, friend.
All right. Jonah's gonna have to wait. Let's have words with the fishermen.
What do you want?
Here. Buy some food for yourself, yes. You fought well. You fought admirably, sir, yes. You nearly had the best of me.
I had to win, but I don't want your family to go hungry. Here, take the purse.
That's... why? Thank you, master.
We still came out on top there. We still benefited. Anyway, I heard mention of... actually, you know what? These are... thinking about the names that I read off on the notice board in Crow's Perch, and the names mentioned by the bookie after we took down Fish Gulper here. These are the names that associated with that fighting contract back in back at Crow's Perch that I wanted to get to anyway, you know. So anyway, we've run a little long here at this point, like 50, 55 minutes. I'm gonna have to wrap things. I'm going to take care of a little business between episodes and probably set off from this town. Actually, I may inquire about some of the contracts. I don't think there's any harm in that, you know. I'm going to have to do them at some point. I'm not in any major rush to get back to Crow's Perch, but I do want to return there, check in with the Baron, see what he has to say. Maybe he directs us back towards the bog, and if not, well, I'll just head for Oxenfurt, you know. But I think next episode you will see a couple of these contracts get handled here in town. And then beyond that, well, who's to say? Appreciate y'all stopping on in for this one. I hope to see you next time, my friends. But of course, and as always, until then, remember why it hurts. Later, all.